Hello and welcome to today's video. Today we'll discuss a numerical in ship stability subject in the topic numerical integration using Simpson's one-third rule in questions which we have half stations. So for an introduction, we know that when we cannot use our normal mathematical formulae or other methods to find out area or volume of a given shape, like a situation comes where we need to find out how much paint has to be applied on a ship's hull. If you take the shape of a ship's hull, it is not resembling any figure, like a if you take a plane figure like a rectangle, circle, parabola, etc. Or if you take a three-dimensional object like a cube, cylinder, so the shape of a vessel, a ship, as you can see in these three photographs here, they do not match with any figures, 3D figures or 2D plane figures which we have studied in mathematics. So we cannot use any mathematical formula to find out area or volume of a ship using our formula. So in these kind of situations, we use techniques in numerical integration. And one of the famous techniques in numerical integration to find out areas and volumes is our Simpson's rule. And Simpson's one-third rule, which we all know, is a rule which we use when we have odd number of data. When odd number of stations are given in a question, we will use the Simpson's one-third rule. Now, a student needs to clearly know in which type of questions, which type of rules are to be applied. Because that will not be mentioned in the questions mostly. So you have to decide which rule is to be applied in which question. So here the question says, a ship 90 meters long is floating on even keel at 6 meters aft. The half ordinates commencing from the forward are as follows. Values are given of half coordinates. The half ordinates 7.5 meters from bow and stern are 2.13 and 3.35 meters respectively. We need to find out the area of water plane and change in draft if 153 tons of cargo is loaded with its center of gravity vertically or the center of rotation of the vessel. Also, we need to find out the center of rotation of the vessel. So, this is how the question is presented. One of the biggest trouble a student faces in questions from this section is, you know, student is highly confused which type of Simpson's rule is to be used, what type of data is given in the question, what are the things which are asked in the question. So first we need to have a clarity on these things. See, count the number of stations, the half ordinates from forward to aft. So there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 stations, half ordinates means stations are given. So because 7 that is there, we can definitely use Simpson's one-third rule. So that is certain. Now there is also a mention of half ordinates which are 7.5 meters from bow and stern. Okay, now this is a very simple thing. For a 90 meter long vessel, there are 7 stations. So if I can draw a figure like this, see, this is a 90 meter long vessel and there are 7 stations which we have numbered from 0 to 6. So the h, the common interval, will be 90 divided by 6, the value of which will be 15. So h in this question is 15, the common interval is 15. So what is given in the question is the half ordinates at 7.5 meters at bow and stern are 2.13 and 3.35 meters respectively. So the question simply means that there is a half station from bow, that is here, and a half station from aft, that is here. And the numbering of these half stations, because it is between 0 and 1, will be half, and between 5 and 6 will be 5.5. This is how the numbering of half stations will be done. So this question has 6 full stations as shown in the yellow color and 2 half stations as shown in green color. Now, students very often get confused between what is half station, what is half ordinate. See, half ordinate simply means you can see the plan of the vessel, the top view. See, only we have taken only half section of the vessel. The other half, which is supposed to come in the bottom, is not taken. Why? Because both these halves, the top and bottom, or the port and starboard halves, are mirror images. So if I simply calculate the area of one half and multiply with 2, I will get the actual value of area. So why should I take the two halves? Only one half is good enough. So that is the reason in this question the data is given as half ordinate. Half ordinate simply means the height of station of half section, only half section. That is why this half ordinate is given. So that is the idea of half ordinates. And in this question, it is written that the half ordinates, which are 7.5 meters, so the total common interval, which we have discussed, is 15, and it is specifically given that the station at which is 7.5 meters from bow. So if this is the bow, 7.5 meters from bow, and 7.5 meters from the aft is the values are given, 2.13 and 3.35. So this is how the data is presented in this question. Also, there's a small thing which you need to know, even though I don't think it will make any difference in the answer of this question. There's one more thing we need to know. See, in this question, it is given a ship 90 meter long is floating at even draft. The half ordinates commencing from forward, starting from forward. Okay, now as far as numbering of stations is concerned, as far as my knowledge goes, there are two methods, two systems in which we do numbering. One is the British system, where we start numbering from aft to forward, and one there is American system, where we start numbering from forward to aft. Okay, so as per this figure, I have taken actually the British system, where the first station is taken at the aft, which I have put station 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 towards the bow. So this is the British system which we very often which we follow in India. This is the system which we follow. But in this question, specifically, they have given the stations are starting from forward. Okay, so please understand this figure as per this question is wrong. Why? Because the numbering has to start from here, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, likewise. But please understand that is not going to make a difference in our answer as far as this question is concerned. So please don't worry about that. I have just mentioned this point for you to understand. See, in any question from Simpson's rule, as I told you, it is very important that you understand what is given in the question. Once you have understood the data given in the question, then you can start solving the question. So now coming to the last part of the discussion, like what is the question? What is asked in the question? Very simple, find the area of water plane, which is definitely what we do. Finding out area is something which we normally do in any question on Simpson's rule. Find the water plane area of this vessel. This data is given, and again they have mentioned find the change in draft if I am adding 153 tons of cargo at this particular draft. Okay, so once I know the water plane area, I can calculate the TPC. Once I know the TPC, I can find out what will be the change in draft if these many tons of cargo is added. That part is also solved. And finally, they have asked the position of LCF, which we will get once we take moment. This is how we have understood the question. And now, the next video, we will look how this question is. Thank you for listening.